Today I want to show you how I organize my art materials by color. I take as a reference the color wheel. If you don't have one like this, one color wheel, you can make your own using your own colors, like this. I start with yellow. As you can see in the color wheel, is a yellow, then yellow orange, orange, and then red orange, red, and then keeps going with the red violet, which is the crimson magenta, then the violet purple, ultramarine blue, phthalo blue, cerulean blue, lighter blue, then with the blue green, then let me just move this. I continue with the greens like viridian, phthalo green, sap green, and green light. I finish with the green light. Then I use the earth colors like yellow ochre, burnt sienna, burnt umber, raw umber, and of course I use also white. Let me show you how it looks with some of my materials. It doesn't matter if I'm using acrylics or oils, pencils, pens. I have here some pencils, intense pencils, and I start with the yellow, continue with the orange, red, purples, blues, greens, earth colors, and black. These are watercolor pencils, and I do the same. Yellows, oranges, reds, blues, greens, and I have a color chart here. I have other pencils too that follow the same system. Yellows, yellows, oranges, reds, blues, purples, greens, then the earth colors. Can be any kind of materials, even watercolors. I also change the position of any well, watercolor well, and move them according to my system. These are watercolor pencils, and I also do the same, as you can see. My yellows, oranges, reds, purples, blues, greens, earth colors, grays, and black. It can be these are oil pastels. I have my color chart here. It's very good to have a color chart for your pencils and pens. See, I have some pens here, and I have more pencils that follow the same system. If you have a watercolor palette, this is the same position of the colors. Okay, I hope this was useful for you today, and thank you. Goodbye.